Narayan students, today we are going to start with our new chapter of geography, chapter 4, agriculture. About this agriculture, George Washington once said that it is the most healthful, most useful and most noble employment of man. The basic idea behind these lines of George Washington was that a person who is involved in agricultural practice not only fulfills his livelihood, the desire for food for himself, but also acts as a source of provider of food for others too. That makes that person noble, and that particular job and employment also noble. India, being a agrarian country and agriculture being an important employment source in our country, agriculture produces most of the food that we consume. Agriculture also produces raw material for various industries. Few thought-provoking facts are that India is the second in the world in the crop output next to China, and both these countries being one of the most populous countries of the world, China being on the first number and India on the second. 1.4 million square kilometers of land in India is under cultivation. Agriculture is India's biggest economy sector and employs about 52.1% of total force. Types of farming. Over the years, cultivation methods in India have changed significantly depending upon the characteristics of physical environment, technology know-how, and socio-cultural practices. Farming varies from subsistence to commercial farming. At present, in different parts of India, the following farming systems are practiced. First is the primitive subsistence farming, then comes the intensive subsistence farming, and the commercial farming. And did you know that agriculture is the largest livelihood provider in rural India? Now, when we listen to a word, primitive subsistence farming, a thought provokes, what does it mean? The primitive subsistence farming is a type of farming which is still practiced in few places in India. It is practiced on small patches of land with the help of primitive tools like hoe, dao, and digging sticks and family or community labor. This type of farming depends upon monsoon, natural fertility of the soil, and suitability of other environmental conditions. It is also called slash and burn cultivation. The farmers clear a patch of land and produce crops on to sustain their family. When the soil fertility decreases, the farmers shift and start cultivating in the same way or a fresh patch of land. This allows nature to replenish the fertility of the soil. Productivity in this type of farming is slow as fertilizers or modern inputs are not used. There are certain different names of slash and burn cultivation in India as well as in the world. As in northeastern states, it is called jhuming. In Manipur, it is called Palmao. Chhattisgarh, it is called Deepa. Andaman Nicobar, also it is called Deepa. In Madhya Pradesh, it is called Bevar and Dhai, Dhaya. In Andhra Pradesh, it is called Podu or Pinda. In Orissa, it is called Koman, Brinda. In Western Ghats, it is called Kumari. Rajasthan, Valir. Himalayan Belt, it is called Khali. And in Jharkhand, it is called Kuruva. Whereas in Mexico and Central America, it is called Milpa. Venezuela, it is called Conucos. Brazil as Roca. Central Africa, it is called Mesoli. Indonesia, it is called Ledang. And in Vietnam, it is called Re. These are all synonymous to the slash and burn cultivation. Now comes the intensive subsistence farming. This farming of type of farming is practiced in areas of high population pressure on land. It is labor intensive farming where high doses of biochemical inputs and irrigation are used to obtain higher production. Though the right to inheritance leading to division of land among successive generations has rendered land holding size uneconomic, the farmers continue to take maximum output from the limited land in the absence of alternative source of livelihood. Thus, there is enormous pressure on agricultural land. Did you know that 12% of world's farmed land is in India? Now comes the commercial farming. In this type of farming, higher doses of modern inputs like high yielding variety of seeds, that is the HYV seeds, chemical fertilizers, insecticides, pesticides are used in order to obtain higher productivity. The degree of commercialization varies from region to region. For example, rice is the commercial crop of Punjab and Haryana. But in Orissa, it is the subsistence crop. Now we come to the plantations. Plantation is a type of commercial farming. It is the type of farming in which a single crop is grown on a large area. The plantation has an interface of agriculture and industry. Plantation use capital intensive inputs with the help of migrant laborers. All that produce is used as raw material in respective industries. Tea plantation in Assam and North Bengal, coffee plantation in Karnataka, banana plantation in southern part of India, rubber plantation in Kerala, bamboo plantation in Northeast India, etc. are some of the important plantation crops grown in India. Since the production is mainly for market, a well-developed network of transport and communication connecting the plantation area, processing industry and market is already present. Cropping pattern. India has three cropping seasons, and they are Rabi, Kharif and Zayid. The Rabi crops are sown in winter from October to December and harvested in summer from April to June. Important crops are wheat, barley, peas, gram and mustard. States such as Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Uttarakhand and Western Uttar Pradesh are main Rabi crop, mainly wheat producing states. Availability of precipitation during winter months due to western temperate cyclones help in the success of these crops. The success of Green Revolution in Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan has also been an important factor in the growth of the Rabi crops. Now we come to the Kharif crops. Kharif crops are sown with the onset of the monsoons in different parts of the country and harvested in September, October. Students, here I would like all of you, as we have done with the map chapter, that we have divided a sheet of paper and on that we have bifurcated few characteristics by means of which we have made the learning part easy. With the crop seasons also, we can divide another middle page sheet of a register in few sections and make our learning easy. Like, if we start from Kharif crops, the heading will be Kharif crops. First section will be the season in which the Kharif crops are grown. So that will be the with the onset of monsoon and harvested in which season? From September to October. Main crops of Kharif are paddy, maize, jowar, bajra, toor, moong, urad, cotton, jute, groundnut and soya bean. That will be the third section for this particular crop. So first was kab hum isko is particular crop ko sow karte hain yani bote hain. Then second section aayega ki kab hum is crop ko harvest karte hain yani fasal ki katai kab hoti hai. Third hai kaun si crops grow ki jati hain as kharif crops. Now miscellaneous, again miscellaneous hamara section aata hai jisme hum different किसी इस पर्टिकुलर चीज़ के मिसले डिफरेंट टाइप की फीचर के बारे में डिस्कशन करते हैं. सो सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट राइस ग्रोइंग रीजन्स आर असम, वेस्ट बंगाल, कोस्टल रीजन्स ऑफ ओरिसा, आंध्र प्रदेश, तमिलनाडु, केरला, महाराष्ट्र, पर्टिकुलरली द कोंकण कोस्ट अलॉन्ग विद द उत्तर प्रदेश एंड बिहार. सो दीज आर द स्टेट अडेरिंग टू द खारिफ क्रॉप्स. नाउ something which is added recently, paddy has also become an important crop in Punjab and Haryana. In states like Assam, West Bengal, Orissa, three crops of paddy are grown in an year. So last three points of this particular kharif crops can be marked as a star in miscellaneous too, because these are different. Now the Zayat crops. The Zayat crop season is short season between Rabi and Kharif. During the summer months, the crops produced are watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetables and fodder crops. So you can mark the transition as the Zayat crops can act as a change of season, short term crop season. As we were talking of bifurcating the three crop seasons, we can make the notes of Rabi crops like when it is sown, when the seeds are sown for this particular crop. So they are, it is in October to December. And when it is harvested, it is harvested from April to June. Now, third section is that important crops which are grown in Rabi season, grown as Rabi crops. So it is wheat, barley, peas, gram and mustard. Now states in which the Rabi crops are grown, so it is Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Uttarakhand, western Uttar Pradesh. Now with in western Uttar Pradesh, it is basically the wheat that is grown in this area as rabi crop. Now, third, as miscellaneous availability of precipitation, or you can mark as weather conditions. The availability of precipitation during winter months due to the western temporary cyclones help the success of these crops. Now, the miscellaneous section of this particular crop is the success of Green Revolution in Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan has also been an important factor in the growth of rabi crops. Now we come to the major crops. A variety of food and non-food crops are grown in different parts of the country depending upon the variations in soil, climate and cultivation practices. The major crops grown in India are rice, wheat, millets, maize, pulses. These are the grains that are grown in as major crops in India. Food crops other than grains are the sugarcane, oil seeds, tea, coffee, and horticultural crops. The third section is the non-food crops. They conclude as rubber, fiber crops, cotton, and jute. And an amazing fact is that India produces 51 major crops. Now, coming to rice. Rice is the staple food crop of a majority of people in India. India is the second largest producer in the world after China. Now, again, coming back to the process of making of notes for this particular type of topics, heading will be the name of the crop, that is rice. Category, it is a staple food. Staple, that is the main food. Then India's rank in producing that particular crop. So over here, it is the second largest after China. Which type of crop is this? Rabi or Kharif or Zayad? It is Kharif. Now temperature, because students, you have to learn many of these crops. So to make this learning process easy, if we divide our section like as I am telling you, it will be very easy for you to memorize things. So it is a Kharif crop. Temperature is between above 25 degrees centigrade with high humidity and annual rainfall above 100 centimeter. So all this will come under the heading of weather required for the particular crop. Next section will be grown, where it is grown. It is grown in the northern and the northeastern India, coastal areas and the deltic regions. Now again, miscellaneous. Development of dense network of canal irrigation and tube wells have made it possible to grow rice in areas of less rainfall such as Punjab, Haryana and western Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan also. So under five major headings, each crop can be dealt very easily. Now, the map section of our this chapter. So, by the help of green marking, I have marked the rice producing areas, major rice producing areas, and the minor areas are been marked with light green. And to specify, we have to only concentrate on the rice major or minor rice producing areas in India only. Now we come to wheat, the second important cereal crop. Again, it is falls. The crop name is wheat. Its importance is that it is the second most important cereal crop. Second, it is the main food crop of India, northern and the northwestern part of the country. Temperature required, it is cool growing season and with bright sunlight at ripeness time. Now, rainfall required is 50 to 75 centimeter. Important growing zones are Ganga, Satluj Plains, Black Soil region in Deccan. States which are producing states, it is Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan and the parts of Madhya Pradesh. So again, if we dissect a particular crop in six divisions, first being the name, second being the type of crop, क्या है हमारे लिए वो कितनी important है, क्या वो staple crop है हमारी, क्या वो हमारा main cereal crop है, इसमें हम लोग divide कर सकते हैं, फिर temperature उसके लिए क्या required है, फिर कितना rainfall required है, फिर major producing areas कहाँ कहाँ हैं, किस type का soil required है, ये हमारे basic headings होती है किसी particular crop के लिए. Now, in this map we have marked the major wheat producing areas with red and light pink for the minor areas. Now the millets, that is the jowar, bajra, ragi, are the most important millets grown in India. इसको हम लोग कभी कभी कहते हैं कि भारी अनाज जिसको कहा जाता है, कोर्स ग्रेन. थ्रू दीज दो दीज आर नोन एज कोर्स ग्रेन्स, दे हैव हाई न्यूट्रिशियस वैल्यू. इनकी जो नरिशमेंट वैल्यू होती है, ये हमारे शरीर के लिए बहुत ही ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट होते हैं. इनमें जो आयरन, मिनरल, कैल्शियम का जो मिक्सचर है या रफेज जो फॉर्म है, वो बहुत ही ज़्यादा हेल्दी होता है हमारे लिए. एंड इसको भी अगेन हम लोग उसी तरह डिवाइड कर सकते हैं कि पहले तो क्रॉप का नेम, मिलेट्स के अंडर में तीन क्रॉप बेसिकली आते हैं हमारे यहाँ, ज्वार, बाजरा और रागी. फिर ये किस टाइप का क्रॉप है, ये कोर्स ग्रेन है. इसको इसके मिसलेनियस में हम डाल सकते हैं, इट इज़ हाई न्यूट्रिशनल वैल्यू. और रागी के लिए स्पेशली डाल सकते हैं कि इट इज़ रिच इन आयरन, कैल्शियम एंड अदर माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड रफेज ऑल्सो. ये हमारा मिसलेनियस चला गया, ये दो पॉइंट. फिर किस टाइप का वेदर इसको सूट करता है, या किस टाइप का सॉइल इसको सूट करता है, तो इस हेडिंग के अंदर में आएगा कि द क्रॉप ग्रोज बेस्ट इन ड्राई रीजन्स एंड ग्रोज वेल ऑन ब्लैक सॉइल, रेड सॉइल, सैंडी सॉइल, लोमी सॉइल एंड शैलो सॉइल्स. कर्नाटक इज़ द लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर. अब किस स्टेट में सबसे ज़्यादा प्रोड्यूस होता है, आ गया कर्नाटक. And the largest producer is the largest producer followed by Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Jharkhand, Arunachal Pradesh are also important ragi producing states. Now comes the jowar. Jowar is the third important food crop with respect to the area of production. It is a rain-fed crop. Now ragi ke liye ek dry region ki zarurat thi. ज्वार के लिए रेन फेड एरियाज़ के लिए, जहाँ पे मॉइस्चर हो, ऐसी एरियाज़ का रिक्वायरमेंट है. सो महाराष्ट्र इज़ द लार्जेस्ट ज्वार प्रोड्यूसिंग स्टेट, फॉलोड बाय कर्नाटक, आंध्र प्रदेश, मध्य प्रदेश. इसको आप एक फ्लो चार्ट के थ्रू भी इसको याद कर सकते हैं. नाउ बाजरा एक सैंडी सॉइल, शैलो ब्लैक सॉइल में ग्रो करना बेस्ट इसके लिए सुटेबल है. That is Rajasthan is the largest producer of bajra, followed by Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Haryana. So three different crops, three different types of soil requirement and three different types of states which are the producers of these different millets. Now in my next video, we'll discuss about few other crops like maize, pulses, sugarcane, tea, coffee, horticultural crops, rubber, fiber crops, cotton. We'll concentrate on these. So till then, students, stay home, stay safe, practice the maps which are shown in previously in the starting of the video till wheat, and do follow all the guidelines related to COVID-19. Till then, stay home, stay safe.